like Joey Tanner. Big spender, Kris Jenner. I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo. She like, oh, it's happening. Think she call me, think she, cause she never knew her daddy. And my all black, Rhythm Nation, Janet. Boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, bodily. What's underground? What's underground? What's underground? What's underground? Frontin' like a ride with the mob. Why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Myself and I. Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll. Holler them all. Struttin' like Pac out the court. Hop out the Porsche. Shake that, got that on menu, the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. Sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was gangin' since the Platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being Hova, I should move it, yay. Listen, babe, listen, so good you'll think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing, I could Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy being truthful, baby. Baby, for real, for real. Overload. This is like I got like my pinky, like my pinky. Money, baby, we don't, baby, we ain't ours. Bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style. Chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF chains down. I gave you prophecy, my first one, then you lame down. Luckily, sold, but it wasn't for me. Still the flow raw, peep the way I bubble in these streets. Who can f*** with me?
Nikki, baby.
I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up it, I'ma squeeze. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. Got it. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't wanna eat. If you say they want, they don't want no steam. She put it on it. Had a bachelor's degree, PhD while selling spellings. Fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self esteem. Hit a block, yo, this flop. Where you at? Pin it. My new map location be the flop. On the app.
Lil' bro,
you can't hang bro. Here.
Getting money, so keep on coming.
Phone
ringing, so you know the jumping. They looking at me, he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the night out the crumpin'.
Why
playing games? They don't want no problems with me. My got good eyes. You know I brought them. Might not hit a bad. Someone, send them for opposition.
They move on.
So I.
Dark shades, too much, I could barely see them. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks? Who want too close? Give me room, phony folks, play it close. Do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad health disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue dungarees.
Flintstone bust down, color Maricami. Fruity pebble bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Back, I'm out of town, I think she model Abercrombie. Wrist game, Lucky Charmy, told my jeweler leprechaun.
I'ma come clean, I got beef. Paranoia got me rolling in my sleeves, okay. Dating cause I'm up and up the freeze. Whole team got these on their T's all day.
I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up it, I'ma squeeze.
I'm above average.
Honorable
C-Notes. Yeah.
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 Big bang rolls, cash. Now she go, for the team. Now she don't skid, splash. Think about folks not on the ground, man, the leader. Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers. Pockets, lettuce, don't think I'm ready. You got that swag, you got that salt, they sell it. Free money, cash them out, we bailing. Saw my teacher, I was the same student fella. Now I got a lawyer, straight cash, no settlement. I'm out my element, out my element. My the same, don't need no clout, no fame.
No clout, no clout.
Bought the game, all brand new chain.
Ice,
swear the lane, call the group the gang.
Gang, gang.
Whip that thing,
whip it.
This shit give me, ooh, yeah. Them boys fool you, trying to do it, bring the,
I do.
Don't want no, they pull up with that,
no.
It's times three, this how it go. Park $1 million at the, we gon' make on eat that until we go.
Eat it up, eat it up.
Rich straight to the top floor.
Top.
More PJs than
PJ.
Rich like water, go to Cabo.
Splash.
Cash in the walls, hollow.
Cash.
Your money too small, micro. Huncho on the call, got a.
Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis, happy to be with you. And Charles, we've got two teams who know each other extremely well. These division games, they tend to be battles.
People scout like crazy in this league, but no one scouts more than within the division. Because if you win your division, you're automatically in the playoffs. That puts extra emphasis on these games, and they can't wait to get at each other.
Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively. They talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon.
I would think as a play call, you want to look for some quick hitters to your tight end. Any type of a route to replace where that linebacker was. Because when you saw the speed with which he reacted and stuffed that play, maybe use that speed against him in the future.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
On the ball.
From the gun, it's Wentz. And incomplete here on third down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Now they're set up nicely at the 45-yard line after the missed field goal from 55. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. He dumps it off to Barkley. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even...
And it's a touchdown! Saquon Barkley, 39 yards. And the Mandalites have taken the early lead.
And that's another route that defenders would vote to take out of the game.
The wheel route?
Oh, without a doubt. You're just trying to move everybody in one direction. And whether it's a running back or another receiver, as they sit out on the sideline, you've got a problem on your hands.
Yeah, well, the defenders hate it there. It happened, and it resulted in a touchdown. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
A little closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
On second down, Williams. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that'll make it 3rd and 13. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's going to loft one deep left side here. This is intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
Well, it's 3rd and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Throw left side, completion to Rice. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
A nice catch there by Jerry Rice. And when you look at the yardage he compiled in his NFL career, it seems staggering at 22,985 yards. But let's put a little context with it.
Yeah, we were in the numbers earlier. Larry Fitzgerald, who was contemplating retirement this past offseason, would need 7 more 1,000-yard seasons to break Jerry Rice's record.
That's context.
Shotgun now for Wentz. This is caught. And this results in 6. Touchdown. Saquon Barkley with his 2nd touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Madden Elites, they extend their lead. Sturgis adds the PAT, and it's now 14-0. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And now back out comes the offense. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Wentz now to throw. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Brandon Graham in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Memphis with the ball here to begin quarter number 2, but they face a second and long to start things out. Rush strong now. That sacks on back-to-back plays. And Charles, this infraction is going to be against the offense.
Sometimes you have to get up to the line of scrimmage, make sure your team is set before you begin your cadence.
So the false start doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long.
About this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks, don't let them get there, and they rallied and made the tackle.
This is brought in at the 21. A good return there, 17 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Madden elites heading back onto the field. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just given them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is, they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
And now they're just looking to add to that total. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they went up a little bit on meetings with the coaching staff there
when we talked about him. They did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue.
And nothing but daylight ahead. And this will be a touchdown. 3 touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Madden elites, they extend their lead.
Yes, indeed. Jerry Rice from Mississippi Valley State. I remember when he broke into the league, and the nickname Flash was the one he was trying to get the catch on. As it turned out, he didn't need a nickname. 197 receiving touchdowns in the NFL. Added on 10 rushing, and even had a fumble recovery for a total of 208 this career.
By far the most all-purpose touchdowns in world history. And this offensive unit ready to see what they're going to do here. That's some dangerous territory. Only down 3 scores, or 3 and out here. An inability to put any points up. This one might be over by now.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. Edelman was the intended target.
That's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Here's Wentz to throw. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for 5.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
They'll run it with Williams. And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Wentz looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Man open, Rice. 9 yards on the pick up there, and it keeps the drive alive. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out with a shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hope the NFC will really throw it on short yardage, so they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
To Barkley on the check down, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a 2nd down. Now Wentz fighting a safety valve here. That's complete. And put it on the board. It's 6, a touchdown. Saquon Barkley on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Madden Elites, they extend their lead. And he's able to put it through. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Sturgis for the extra point. Of course, they have the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
This fielded at the 2. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And here now the offense heading back out there. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah.
You know, take your time, first half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big-time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. And on 3rd and inches, we're going to get a whistle and a timeout as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. The offense on 3rd down tonight, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got a 1st down as he's up to the 48. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken in at the 1. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this 3rd quarter. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. And they'll go on the ground. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for them. Show them that you're supposed to get the football.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. They stick to the ground game on first down. It's Williams. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of 4.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time, 9 yards, and the sticks move again. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think for the offensive coordinator, he's got to go to that side of the play sheet that says, try something different. Try some specials, something they haven't seen all day to try and get this offense kickstarted.
And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down.
One of the things I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? It's like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
So 2 missed field goals for them now, and that's helped keep them with a big 0 on the scoreboard.
Well, it's not the only reason they have a 0. The offense has been bogged down a few times now, but it's certainly not helping the cause any at all.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Out to his left, and that's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Now Wentz. Ertz over the middle. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his 2nd catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their 3rd corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
Wentz now, pretty amazing. 14 of 16 throwing the ball. It's 1st and 10. Now, Wentz again. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll go down at the 28. A gain of 6 there on first. Back now in Atlanta. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Wentz to throw again. And he checks this one down to Williams. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and take him to like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down.
Great.
Again, it's Wentz. Able to get away. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. What, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
On third and long, it's Wentz. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And he will take it out to the 25-yard line. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Edelman, the intended receiver that time. They'll hand it off now, Williams. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he will have a touchdown. Ricky Williams, an 8-yard touchdown run. And his guys capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. So up comes Wentz as he and the guys on offense here will go for two.
82.
Throwing is Wentz. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. Jakeem Grant now to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26.